Ella McCauley of Pray It Up in Syracuse, New York. This is powerful. 7 foods you can eat compulsively for that oral fixation without getting fat. Broccoli. Yay! We can overeat on broccoli and not get fat. Hearts of palm. Who here has ever had hearts of palm? I've never had it. See, it's, look it up. They sell it everywhere. What? It's in a can. Look.
You can get it in water, in an olive oil, but you mix it in with your salad.
You can mix it in with salad, okay? You can eat as much of it as you want, but don't eat it with the oil. Get it plain. Cherry tomatoes, to me, are like candy. I love them. I love them. Water chestnuts. You know, I love water chestnuts, and I never eat them. Why not? Why don't we get some water chestnuts and put it in salad? Let's just load up on it. Apples, celery, and artichokes. Do you know they sell apples in the stores in March? Did you know that? Wow. I wonder why none of you have apples on your food log then. People are like, I do. I know you do. Also, so what one of these, I want you to pick one of these and have it next week. All right, last week I had cherry tomatoes, and that's it on the whole list. But next week, I'm going to have water chestnuts and apple. No, I give up fruit for mine. I'm going to have water chestnuts and hearts of palm. All right, 7 ways to tweak your routine that'll help you lose weight. I want you to pick one or more of these and talk about it in small group. 30 grams of protein for breakfast, that's a lot of protein. A heavy dose of egg beaters, a protein smoothie, but like I said, I want food. Lift those weights. When's the last time you picked up those hand weights and moved them around? I love this. Wind down with a bath. When's the last time I told my bath story? Was it, do you guys remember it right offhand? Jane does. Real quick bath story. The last time I took a bath was September 27th of 1995. And you might say, Ellen, you remember the exact date? And I do. It was 25 years ago. It was the day before I gave birth to Vincent. I was 9 months pregnant and I was huge. And I said to Bob, you know, they're going to be in every little nook and cranny. I think I'm going to take a bath. I could not get out of the tub. Bob, poor Bob, was looking at this beached whale and this thinking, oh my gosh, I'll never be able to walk again if I get her out of this tub. We almost called 911. And I turned my eyes to heaven like, Jesus, get me out of this tub. Somehow I did, but I have post-traumatic stress, so I have not taken a bath since September 27, 1995. So I think that this Sunday, I'm going to take a bath and then go into my sanctuary and meditate on my fainting couch and have Bob take a picture of me in the bathtub with careful bubbles, you know, whatever. All right. But I think everyone should take a bath to wind down. Log off when you clock out. How many people have trouble falling asleep at night that are still working because you're planning your next day and you're getting all nervous about it, especially Sunday night? Anyone have Sunday night work syndrome? I do. Also, plan your meals once a week. Bob and I plan it on Saturday and Sunday. We cook a lot on Saturday and Sunday. And then ban mid-show eating. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, no snacks, and guess what? We survived. Cleaning routine, do a little bit every day. I went to visit Vince, Bob and I went to visit Vince in New York City, and they've got a double chrome sink. And after we were all cleaning up everything, he took paper towels and he wiped all the water out of the sink, and the sinks were sparkling because that's what we do. That's what we've always done. And I looked at my 24-year-old son realizing they do pay attention. He wants a sink to look like the sinks at home. You do a little bit every day. We don't go to bed with dirty dishes. A little bit every day. And then all of a sudden, it's good. I'm going to stop right there, Bob.